Let's talk about Google Analytics 360 properties. If you are a large company, you may have multiple teams that need to access different insights depending on their job function, products, and markets. The more complex your business, the more data you're likely to have. Google Analytics 360, or GA360, is the enterprise version of analytics and was built with this in mind. While standard analytics properties are free to use, GA360 properties have additional paid features that help larger and more complex organizations. For example, GA360 can scale as you grow your business and as your data needs grow with it. It has higher data limits than the standard Google Analytics properties. You'll also get continuous intraday data via Analytics 360's interface or the API. Data usually appears within an hour after collection, so you can make faster, near real-time decisions during crucial periods for your business, like during a promotion or a busy season. GA360 properties offer additional customization with higher limits for custom dimensions, custom metrics, and user properties. GA360 properties also offer more flexibility to manage access to your properties and data. Let's walk through two useful features of GA360 for data management: subproperties and rollup properties. A subproperty is a property that gets its data from another property, known as a source property. You can filter events from the source property so that only a subset appears in the subproperty. Subproperties then can give you greater control over user access to your data because you can grant someone access to only a subproperty instead of an entire source property's unfiltered data. For example, suppose you have a property for your brand and want to separate out the data for each region you operate in. You could create one subproperty per region and then grant some users access to one region's data while granting other users access to another region's data. Those users would see only the data relevant to them, while you could still collect and view the unfiltered data in the source property. You work with a subproperty in the same way you would an ordinary property, with a few restrictions. For example, subproperties can't have events of their own. All of its events must first exist in its source property. And you can't add or delete data streams, import offline events, or modify and create events via the user interface in a subproperty. You can, however, use audience triggers in a subproperty. Just keep in mind that any data that you delete from a source property is also deleted from its subproperties. Let's go through the steps to create a new subproperty in GA360. We'll start in admin. In the top left corner, click the Create button, and then choose Property. In the pop-up window, choose Subproperty and click Create. You'll see a list of GA360 source properties to choose from. Select the property that you'd like the subproperty to get its data from. Give your subproperty a name and select the time zone and currency. Acknowledge the cost associated with the subproperty and click Next. Next, click Create Filter to configure the include and exclude conditions that will define which event data from the source property will appear in the subproperty. You can use and or logic when you create conditions. For example, you can configure an include condition like country exactly matches Netherlands and language is English. You can also use the or option to specify that the value for the dimension is not set, meaning it has no defined value. For example, country exactly matches Netherlands or country exactly matches not set. When you've finished configuring the conditions for the filter, click Confirm, then click Next. Select an industry category for the subproperty and the size of the business you will measure with the subproperty, and then click Next. Then choose the reasons you use analytics. These selections will set up the subproperty's reporting interface. Finally, click Create. After you create a subproperty, you control it independently from its source property and can add users and configure their access just as you would for any other property. Keep in mind, to create a subproperty, you must be an administrator and the source property must be an ordinary property. You cannot create a subproperty from another subproperty or a rollup property, which we'll talk about now. Rollup properties can provide a broad view of your business across products, brands, or regions by combining data from multiple source properties into a single roll-up property. For example, if you have a separate property for multiple brands that your company owns, you can roll those up to a single roll-up property that provides an aggregate look at how those brands perform. Let's see how to create one in a GA360 property. We'll start back in admin. In the top left corner, click the Create button and then choose Property. In the pop-up window, choose Rollup Property and click Create. Give it a name and select the time zone and currency. Acknowledge the cost associated with the Rollup Property and click Next. Then, in the Source Properties row, click Choose Properties. We'll see a list of properties that we can choose to include in this Rollup Property. You can select up to 200 source properties to be included. Once you've selected the properties you want, click Confirm. Click Next, then provide the industry and business information. Click Next once again, then choose the reasons you use analytics. These selections will set up the Rollup Properties reporting interface. Once ready, click Create to finish. You can always add or remove source properties after you create the Rollup Property from this same section in the admin menu. To recap, we talked about three types of properties today. First, there are ordinary properties, and those can become source properties when associated with subproperties or rollup properties. A subproperty gets its data from a source property, typically including a subset of data and restricting access for more granular analysis. Rollup properties do the opposite. They aggregate data from multiple source properties for higher level reporting. Below, you'll find some example businesses and how each has used subproperties and rollup properties, as well as some other features of GA360 properties.